Let me see if I can answer this, but I will answer in a different way, but let me try. See, the transition to, let's say, from diesel to EVs or hybrids, we expect that somebody else will come and do it for us. Let's say we expect the government or the agencies or the OEMs will come and create solutions for us, and we'll just accept it. I don't think that will work today. I mean, just to give an example, we have electric scooters available in India. We have electric cars. How many of us will go and buy today? Electric vehicle buying is just one step. We need to have the confidence of that we can charge it whenever I want. I need assurance of power that I will get a power whenever I want to charge. And the vehicle will run so many kilometers before it is, I don't want to get stranded in the middle of the road. So there are many aspects of the ecosystem which will get addressed, and those are being addressed, but it'll take their own time. So everyone, even the customers, have to participate in doing this transition. And I'm not sure if only the OEMs or only the government will push that we are going bringing EVs, bringing BS6 or bringing whatever new technologies, it'll happen automatically. Today, even after, let's say, after pandemic, today in situation, the economic conditions are not good for many of the, let's say, companies, people, fleet owners, or whatever segment you can take. Would you like to spend money, or where would you like to spend money today? So there are many questions, many aspects to do a good transition from one technology to another. It's not only technology. Technology is available. Whether it's making sense, whether people are comfortable using it, that's going to be a big differentiating factor, which will decide when we transition, how we transition, what are the challenges in transition. I'll give you an example. Today, I live in a society where there's a building, it has 9 floors. A person who has a flat on 9th floor wants to buy a electric car, but he has a open parking. He doesn't have a parking slot fixed for him. Where do you think he'll put a charger? It's a serious question to be. I mean, you go to a electricity department, ask for a meter, dedicated meter. So what it comes down today is, I mean, I'm just making a, trying to understand what would it need. I need a land, I need a power connection, I need some kind of security that it doesn't get stolen or doesn't get damaged. So it's as good as like putting an ATM. So buying a vehicle is one step, but to support that vehicle, you need so many other things to make sure that things are working. But I would say it's a challenge. People are coming with solutions. Definitely there are roadmap available. There are many, I would say, opportunities there, but it will take their own time. We also have to accept as a customer to be a part of the transition and make it happen as smoothly or as quicker as possible. Because look at the compliance part. Today we say we have BS4, BS3, BS6 vehicle. And how that is being checked for compliance? We have a PUC van sitting, standing somewhere in the corner. We get a certificate and that's okay, you are compliant. But I think last 1 year, it has become online. Now the tracking is much more rigorous and much more, I would say, authentic. Before that, it was just a question of getting a slip. So compliance is our responsibility. You can't say that, okay, if my vehicle is throwing a lot of black smoke, I don't care. I will not go and spend money to repair it. So I think every person in the ecosystem has to play a part to do a transition. And I'm not sure if that's the right answer. That's what my broad understanding is.